major disaster may be unfolding right now in Haiti, hit today by a powerful earthquake.
In addition to those trying to survive under the rubble, of course,
there at this intersection, there are actually bodies blocking the street on the corner there, and we're right next to a gas station. Which
it was a magnitude 7, possibly the strongest quake ever to hit that region.
The hardest part about today has been all the survivors who've asked us for food and water.
Today we get off the plane and we walk into the airport, and it's like every other airport, normal air conditioning. Catch a small bus over to customs, get through customs easy, baggage claims interesting. We grab our bags, we walk through customs, and I see something I've never seen before. I see this mass group of people standing at these gates, almost begging for attention, begging to help, looking for money, and this starts the beginning of our trip.
Hey, Chris.
Hey, grab your bag.
Okay, okay.
Grab your bag.
What?
Yes.
Abel.
Huh?
What's going on?
Yeah,
go
on.
Just to take your white bag. Take your white bag with you. And
buy
me cela.
That's it for now. I'm going to get
my sixth time coming to Haiti, and every time I come, God always does something new in my life. And just getting off the plane and coming in to Haiti since the earthquake, just seeing how differently it feels. We did come right after the earthquake, and we just saw such destruction and people in despair.
And I step out in the street, I get in the car, we go down the street, we drive through downtown Port-au-Prince.
With the refugees, how long can you keep them?
An organization and some office to win some tent for them, find a place for them.
Yeah.
But they don't do nothing yet.
You feel so helpless in times like this, like what can I do, you know, but sometimes a hug or a smile to a kid or a high five or just making someone laugh or playing basketball, that's one of the greatest things you can do.
Great, man. That's your first trip in Haiti?
Yeah. Yeah, first time.
Off the plane, I just felt that there was something different in the atmosphere. And I really believe that people's hearts are changing towards God. I didn't feel that oppressive spirit here. I didn't feel anything like that. I just felt that there was kind of more of a liberty in the spirit. Hey, look behind you right now.
When I'm at the pearly gates, this will be on my videotape. Mephistopheles is just beneath and is reaching out to grab me. This is one for the good days, and I have it all here in red, blue, green, and red, blue, green. And you are my center when I spin away out of control.
Today we went back to downtown Port-au-Prince, and it even intensified what we saw yesterday. People do not want to go inside of the buildings because they're afraid of the aftershocks. Since we've been here, there's been, I think, 4 or 5 aftershocks. One that I've actually felt, and 4 that I've actually heard in the mountains. And these people are terrified because every day they're hearing and feeling these aftershocks, and they don't want to go inside the building. So they're living outside. I mean, as you can see, there's people everywhere, and they're intense, and it's just part of what they're doing now, and they're fighting for survival at every turn. I mean, I looked in the eyes of the people, and there wasn't much hope in a lot of them.
It was a little baby. It was under the house, like the house fall and hit the next one on the bottom. It go down the ground. Nah, you can't see under the ground. The baby's
sister, all
right? In the ground. 11
is
days.
Is still alive?
Baby have, you know, like, you know, it was somebody coming to the babies, man. Feed the babies. The baby ain't died. 11 days, babies. 1 year. That's to show you God's will.
Jesus,
God's will, man.
You shouldn't be afraid, 'cause I know today has been the most perfect day I've ever seen.
So we just unloaded the rice off the truck. It was kind of a crazy experience. I was sitting there, and the truck pulls up, and I start to see guys come up with bags of rice. And not only are they bringing bags of rice, but there's an American flag on the bag of rice. And just we throw this rice over our back, and these people, it's almost as you're walking through, you see in their eyes, they see hope. They see more days ahead. They see food. They see life in your shoulders as you're walking this up the hill. And it was a crazy experience. One of the cool things was, as I look, and like little 8-year-old boys are popping bags of rice on their back, and they're walking up the hill, and they're willing to pitch in, because this is a team effort, and everybody realizes that they have to do their part if they want to survive, if they want to keep have another day. And I'm just glad we got to be a part of that and help out.
Also, we got to go to Lagon, where High Point Church is building a brand new church there, and we're reaching other people. And so it's just really cool just doing that. I got to see another part of the city.
Like your hands.
It was all hands, man.
Oh, my gosh.
There's a big pile of rocks right here, and we're just dumping them.
That hole.
That was 16 feet down. He was like, what are we doing?
That's this one right here.
Stage platform.
Stage.
We're going to preach.
Preach?
Preach the gospel.
Preach the gospel.
overall, my experience on this trip has been great. Again, like I said from the very beginning, every time I come on missions, I always ask God, do something new in my life. You know, if there's anything in me that you need to work on, let it be now. Because for me, I really want God's fullness in my life.